students, today we are going to discuss about homogeneous linear differential equation, which is also called Euler-Cauchy's differential equation. So in my previous video, you have learned how to find CF and PI of linear differential equation with constant coefficients. Now we are going to learn linear differential equation with variable coefficients. So here I have considered this linear differential equation of nth order with variable coefficient. As you can see, derivative is multiplied with independent variable here, but homogeneous is a special case of linear differential equation with variable coefficients. So how will you recognize that the given linear differential equation is homogeneous or not? For that, suppose we have x square d square y by dx square plus x dy by dx plus y. So is it homogeneous? Yes. When the derivative is multiplied with independent variable and the derivative's order and independent variable power both are same and multiplied together, and this rule is followed thoroughly the equation, then you can say the given linear differential equation is homogeneous. So what we need to check? We need to check the independent variable is multiplied with the derivative and the order of derivative and power of independent variable are same. So you can observe in this equation, in this linear differential equation, here we have nth order, here we have power n multiplied with x, here we have n minus 1 order, here we have power n minus 1, and this rule has been followed in the whole equation. So this kind of equation is called homogeneous linear differential equation. So to solve, to find complete solution of such kind of equation, we have to follow some steps. We need to substitute x is equal to e to the power z. So step 1 will be, first of all, we have to substitute x is equal to e to the power z, which will imply z is equal to log x, and here d is d by dz. Okay, what we have to consider here, we will write multiplication of x and d by dx, we will consider it as capital D. If we have x square d to dx square, we will consider it d into d minus 1. If we have x cube d cube dx cube, then we will consider it d into d minus 1, d minus 2, and so on. So these are the steps. So then what will happen? Our differential equation will change into y with respect to z, and then it will be reduced to linear differential equation with constant coefficients with y with respect to z. Then we will find CF and PI using the rule, that will be in terms of z, and finally we will replace z by log x. Okay, so let us consider one example. Solve So our question is, solve x cube Okay, so this is the question. We have to solve it, means we have to find both parts, we have to find CF as well as PI. Okay, so first of all, what we have to observe, it is homogeneous or not? Okay, so see here, here order is 3, power is 3, order is 2, power is 2, here y to the, here no derivative, no x to the power 0, that is 1. So this is homogeneous differential equation. Now move further, step 1 will be, we have to consider what? X is equal to e to the power z, and this implies z is equal to log x. This will be first step. Then after, what we have to do? We have to reduce this differential equation to LDE with constant coefficients. So take it d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 as it is of order 3 plus here 2 d into d minus 1 plus 2. Write y outside, then 10, and in place of x we will write e to the power z 1 upon x will be e to the power minus z. Okay, now simplify it. This is d, d d minus 1, d minus 2. So it is d into d square minus d minus 2d minus 3d plus 2 plus 2d square minus 2d plus 2 y is equal to 10 e to the power z plus 10 e to the power minus z. So it is d cube minus 3d square plus 2d plus 2d square minus 2d plus 2 y is equal to 10 e to the power z plus 10 e to the power minus z. Now you can simplify it. Here 2d minus 2d cancelled out. So finally we have d cube minus 3d square plus 2d square is minus d square, and then we have plus 2. D cube minus d square plus 2 y is equal to 10 e to the power z plus 10 e to the power minus. So you can observe here we have reduced this differential equation into LDA with the constant coefficients. Now we can find its CF at PI. So for CF we required auxiliary equation. We will replace d by m, m cube minus m square plus 2 is equal to 0. Now we have to find roots of m. Using Heaton trial, you can say here minus 1 plus 2. So minus 1 satisfied. So one root is minus 1. For another root, you can use calculator also to find out its root. So we have minus 1. So MF1 we can divide the whole equation by it. M cube minus m square plus 2. This is called Heaton trial method. So here m square, m cube minus m square and plus 2. Here minus plus. This is cancelled. This is cancelled. Just a minute. I'm stating some. This is m cube minus m square plus 2. So take m square, so it is m cube plus m square, right? Minus, minus. So this is cancelled out, and here we have minus 2m square plus 2. Then we will multiply with 2m minus 2m. So it is minus 2m square and minus 2m plus, plus. This is cancelled. So we have 2 plus 2m. So 2. 2 plus 2m. Minus minus. This is cancelled 0. So this is quadratic equation. So one root is minus 1. For another root, we will solve this quadratic equation. So m is equal to 2 plus minus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. I have used that formula. All of you are aware with this formula. So this is minus 4, that means it will be 2i. So we have roots 1 plus minus iota. Okay, so roots are m is equal to minus 1 and 1 plus minus iota. Okay, so now we have to write CF. So CF will be, we have three roots, one is real number and two are complex. So use that formula, C1 e to the power minus z plus e to the power z C2 cos z plus C3 sin z. Okay, so since we have reduced the differential equation in y with respect to z. Okay, so CF and PI both will be in form of z. So here this is the CF. Now for PI we have 10 e to the power z upon d cube minus d square plus 2 and plus 10 e to the power minus z upon d cube minus d square plus 2. So we have exponential rule number 1. So in rule number 1, if you have exponential function, d will be replaced by a. What is a here? Coefficient of z. So a is 1. So replacing d by 1, we have 1 minus 1 plus 2. Here, replacing d by 1 minus 1, so it will be minus 1 and minus 1 plus 2. So what will happen here? Here you can see the denominator is 0, which is case of failure. Okay, so first, solving first part, 10 e to the power z, 2, and 2, 10 is 5. So we have 5 e to the power z. For second part, you know if you have case of failure, what we will do? We will differentiate denominator with respect to d. So it will be 3d square minus 2d. Okay, since we have differentiated one time, so write z one time in numerator. Now we have 5 e to the power z plus 10z e to the power minus z. Again, you have to check by replacing d with minus 1. So it is 3 minus 1 minus minus plus. So 2. So it will be 5. Okay. So our PI is 5 e to the power z plus 2z e to the power minus a. So complete solution will be what? Sum of CF and PI. So complete solution y is equal to CA plus PI. CF is C1 e to the power minus z plus e to the power z, C2 cos z plus C3 sin z plus PI is 5 e to the power z plus 2z e to the power minus z. What is z here? Either you can write here where z is log x, okay? Or you can replace also. So if I will replace z by log x, what will happen? C1 upon x. Here x into C2 cos log x, C3 sin log x plus 5x plus 2 log x divided by x. So this is the complete solution of the given homogeneous linear differential equation. Okay, so I hope you understand how to solve the homogeneous linear differential equation and how to recognize this. Okay, so remember all the steps.